Ketamine seems to work on opening up the unconscious mind. As you may know already, the human mind consists of the conscious mind and the unconscious mind. Things that we are aware of are conscious, and the things that we are unaware of are unconscious. So one metaphor to explain this would be like, imagine an iceberg. So when you see an iceberg, you see the tip of the iceberg, and if someone were to go underneath in a scuba gear and go underneath the water, they would actually see a large chunk of that iceberg that's underneath. Similarly, we have the conscious mind, which is that tip of the iceberg that you can see floating above the water, and then you have the unconscious that's buried underneath the water. Ketamine, in a way, allows patients, especially at the dose we're using, which is the sub-dissociative dose, access into the unconscious mind. It makes what's unconscious visible, and so patients will have memories that have been repressed or buried. Patients might have experiences or feelings that they've been holding down, and you know, this might release tears and emotions, or it might release joy. But the important thing is to do a deep dive into the unconscious mind, because that's actually what's controlling a lot of our thoughts and actions, is what's happening on that unconscious level. And by going in there into the unconscious, doing that deep dive, we're able to explore, hey, what are some of the mechanisms? What are some of the things that are driving me? Or, you know, what's the root of this depression or anxiety or PTSD? And so ketamine is cool because it allows the patient to undergo this dissociative experience and explore what's actually really going on in the unconscious mind. Well, that's a bit about ketamine, the conscious mind, and the unconscious mind. If you have any questions, please leave me a message, comment below. Appreciate you joining me today.